Hi, good afternoon, everyone. So I'm Weiling, and I started the community sharing website for Upcipes.com. So essentially, we are a website, a platform that encourages people to upcycle, and that henceforth the name, it's where you share upcycling recipes with the community. So just a little bit of caveat, I have nothing that you can buy for your Christmas festivity this year. And in fact, what I'm going to try and encourage you to do this Christmas is to buy less and actually do more, create more things. So how can we actually upcycle when it comes to festivities like Christmas, right? I'm not sure if let me just share my screen right now. Okay, I hope you can see my screen. So yeah, not sure how many people know about the term upcycling. So, I mean, we're very used to the term recycling, but what exactly does upcycling mean, right? We're familiar with recycling, but and we know that recycling is, you know, taking things, breaking them down into their original form, and then making new things out of them. And this is where I like to propose that actually recycling as a concept is actually quite the opposite of what upcycling does. It's actually downcycling. If you think about it, we take a plastic bottle that we think is going to be recycled. What's happening is that it gets transported to a material recovery facility. It gets broken down into plastic scraps, plastic pellets, and then it gets transported somewhere else and made into a different product, yet another plastic bottle. And here's where upcycling comes into place, where upcycling is actually delivering more value than recycling. When we think about recycling and what it does is that you put in a lot of resources, effort, energy, and you are actually reducing the product that it was made into something less. Whereas here, I like to propose that upcycling is taking that same thing and making something more out of it, increasing the value, bringing it up the value chain. And what I mean is, for example, the same concept of that plastic bottle that I mentioned earlier, instead of breaking it down into plastic pellets, small plastic scraps to be then made into something else, we use it as it is. We make it into, for example, an organizer or a planter and many other things. And here, here's where, you know, you're actually conserving all that was originally put into manufacturing this plastic bottle and not wasting the resources that had gone into it, but actually deriving more value from it. I propose that this is something that is more creative because you actually have to think about, hey, what can I make out of that plastic bottle? And then it's thoughtful. You think about how you're going to make the new thing out of that plastic bottle. You think about the properties of the thing that you're making. And it also gets more personal. You create that planter, that stationery organizer. You're painting it. You're designing it to however you want it. There's nothing else like it out there in the market. So now into Christmas, you know, when we think about Christmas, it's decorations. We see Christmas lights everywhere. We see Christmas trees. And Christmas trees like a big theme for Christmas. The thing is, how many Christmas trees are actually felled every year? It's 100 million across the year, just so that they can stand in our house for 2 weeks, that we put some lights on and you know, smell a bit of the Christmas tree and bring the Christmas atmosphere. And, you know, each Christmas tree takes about 6 to 8 years to grow. think of all the land, water, resources that go into growing each of these Christmas tree. I guess in Singapore, we have less of a culture of buying live Christmas tree because we don't have the space to actually put a huge Christmas tree. But there's also quite a lot of waste that goes into buying plastic Christmas trees. So I like to propose and maybe suggest that we could also make really cool, pretty, artistic Christmas trees out of old materials. So things like glass bottles. The picture on the very left, it's made out of hundreds of glass bottles put together with lights in it. It looks beautiful. It's a piece of art. It can be made out of old aluminium cans, stashed together. So these are everyday items that we have in our homes that we can use for making something like a Christmas tree that is the centerpiece of a Christmas decoration. But we can also make other forms of decorations out of old and used materials. So the picture on the top right is actually the top of a plastic bottle. So I showed a picture of how the bottom part of the plastic bottle was made into organizers, planters, and the top parts can actually be made into decoration pieces. And that's how we make full use of something as simple and something that we rarely value, like a plastic bottle that we, you know, would otherwise just chuck into the waste bin. And at the bottom is something that's featured on my website, upcipes.com. It's tea light candle holders made out of used tuna cans. So you can paint them red and green, make them into really cute Christmas decorations from your homes. And these cost nothing, literally nothing. And but what it brings is color, personalization to your home, and an activity that you can do with your family, your kids, very easily. So here's a picture of a really famous Christmas tree, I guess probably one of the most famous Christmas tree in the world. Maybe some of you know where this picture, this Christmas tree stands, but it stands in Rio de Janeiro. It's a Christmas tree that is, you know, a timeless piece. It stays in its fixed position throughout the year. And what I'm trying to convey with this picture is that Christmas trees, it's a symbol. And you can have a symbol that is everlasting, that changes. So what happens is every year there is a different motif that is being casted on this Christmas tree, and people will travel to see this Christmas tree, right? And it does, and it's reused every year. There's very little that goes into recreating this Christmas tree in terms of brand new resources. And that's what we could do for our own homes as well, you know. Just using things that we already have and existing ornaments and pieces to create decorations out of. You know, when we talk about Christmas, we are also talking about parties. I guess this year with the COVID restrictions, there's less of huge parties that we can host at our homes. But every year, doing festivities, doing events like Christmas, we use up a lot of disposables. You know, at least 30% more disposables are being used each festive season. And there is a very easy way that we can just reduce that. So for example, when we are engaging caterers or making takeouts, you know, bringing our own containers for takeouts is a great way. But even caterers, there are more and more caterers out there in the market that are doing catering services with reusable utensils and cutlery, and that's what we can opt for. And also, when we talk about upcycling, it's very simple things like used glass jars and containers that we can clean and repurpose as glasses and mugs when we have our friends over. So yeah, we can do without the straw in those jars, But that's the whole idea behind it, making use of things that we can repurpose into something else that we need. So we do not buy and dispose more and more every time we celebrate something. Then we have what we love the most, presents during Christmas. An average Singaporean spends thereabouts of $120 each year on Christmas gifts. So there is actually a really good and meaningful way to show the loved ones, our friends, our family that we care at, by spending less in terms of dollars, but spending more in terms of thought and effort by making them things out of things that are already in our homes, things that actually carry meaning for them. So over here, what I'm showing is a series of products that have been made by upcyclists that are part of the Upcipes community. So on the left-hand side is really intricate jewelry made out of used jeans material. And this creator actually sells them online. And this is what I mean by when you have, for example, if you think you're not great at creating something yourself, you can also look into buying items that are upcycled and made from sustainable processes and materials, right? And then you have, for example, in the middle of the screen, it's a plushie made out of old jersey materials. So it's a piece of jersey clothing that is no longer worn. It's been made into a plushie. So I actually ran a campaign with like the Frisbee community where we got many of the old players who stopped playing in the scene to donate back their jerseys. We resold some of them to new players because the old players no longer wear their jerseys anymore. But also some of the ones that can't be worn anymore, they can be repurposed and recreated into items that, for example, was really cool for some of the kids of the older players. They're like, oh yeah, this cute toy that was made out of a competition jersey that was really meaningful and valuable to me in the past. And then on the right side, it's cute little masak-masak toys that are made out of old fabric. And if you can see, it's also held in a container, which used to be like an old sushi tray. So that's really fun if you have toddlers at home and you just want to, you know, play masak-masak with them. You can make their masak-masak toys out of old fabric. And I really like this concept. It's really cool. I'm not sure if you noticed, IKEA also has fabric masak-masak toys now. But those are mass-produced. They are made out of new materials, new resources. Whereas, you know, something as simple as at home, you can make them out of old clothes, right? And this is what some of the things that I have done, my friends have done. It's, you know, taking old school uniform and making cushion covers out of them. So old school uniform, they have real sentimental value to you, but you can't wear them anymore. There's no occasion for you to wear them anymore, but you can make them into home furniture that like cushion covers. And, you know, it's a part of your home and it, you know, it brings this warm, cozy feeling. And this is what I mean. If you have a best friend from school, why not make a nice cushion cover out of your old school uniform for them? It could be really thoughtful and really meaningful. And then on the right, it's small little things like making hairpins out of old accessories, broken accessories. But then on the bottom right, it's like a picture of a rope mat made out of old climbing ropes. So I have a friend who does rock climbing quite a lot, you know, and as a present for his mom during Mother's Day, he actually made her a rope mat out of his old climbing rope. And his mom really enjoyed that, really liked the present because it's so symbolic of what her son loves to do, right? So these are just small little things, and that's what I meant by, you know, you get creative when you're engaging in upcycling, and you create things that are very thoughtful and meaningful for and personal for the person that who's receiving that present. So there's a lot and a long way that can go with an activity like upcycling. And then with presents, you know, we wrap them up in wrappers, and that's also a lot of waste, single-use packaging that ends up in the trash when we buy presents from the malls. Whereas when we make something, it is pretty beautiful and presentable in and of its own. And we do away with a lot of the waste that otherwise comes about with purchases out there. So what I'd like to highlight is that with upcycling, what we actually reduce the waste, because something that was originally meant for the waste bin is now being created and transformed into something that, you know, has actually more value than before. And because we have created that thing, we no longer need to buy something else from the mass market, therefore reducing the strain on production and therefore saving resources that would otherwise go into the creation of these products. So there's actually a study that has been done that if even just 50% of our stores out there in the markets sell things that have been upcycled, reproduced from old materials, that would greatly help the world in terms of the strain in resources. As we know, part of what's going on right now is that we're running out of resources, but factories continue to produce and produce, people continue to buy and buy. And if we were to have more of a culture where things are being circulated back into the system and into the ecosystem, creating a more circular use, then it would help to break that that chain of linear production, producing something that, you know, is used once, twice, and then ends up in the landfills. So it's also a great activity that you can do with your family. Christmas, yes, it's a great season. You receive presents, but it's also a time where friends and family get together. And what better time to spend with your children, with your family, than to make things together, create something, get creative together. And Upcipes as a website, as a community, actually was created during the COVID period, where a lot of people were really staying at home. They were looking at things to do. And, you know, during COVID, I think one of the trends is that more and more people were starting to cook and bake at home, learning to cook and bake at home. But the other thing was also, you know, they were looking for things to engage with their kids with. So crafts and upcycling was really one of the great ways where we could just keep the kids entertained as well. So this is how, you know, an example of like how some of the recipes on the websites look like. So it's a completely free resource that you can go on to check out some of the step-by-step guides. There are some of the recipes even have videos on how to make certain things. So if there's something interesting, you know, get your hands on them this Christmas and yeah, try getting your hands on upcycling. So you can follow us on Upcipes at Upcipes on Instagram, or you can visit the Upcipes website. I mean, the floor is now open for questions if you have any. So maybe I can share a picture of, maybe I can share the website via Zoom, just so you can see how the live website looks like, how you can navigate from recipe to recipe, register as part of the community, become a user, become hopefully also a creator to some of the cool creations that you've done. So this is the website, upcipes.com. And if you scroll down, there are just thumbnails of different recipes that have been shared by the creators community. Some of these creators actually organize workshops as well. Some of them have their own online websites where they sell their creations. And this is an example of what was created out of the climbing rope over here. There's a step-by-step guide, tools that you need, materials that you need, and also a video of the entire creation process. I think we have a question here. Any that you think would be great for a virtual Christmas party? Off the top of my head, I think what could be fun during a virtual Christmas party is to have an activity that you can do together with other participants. So it could be something very simple, one of the activities that I will be conducting with a group of NUS students is actually creating crochet out of old plastic bags. So I think previously in one of the sessions, we were looking, one of the, I think eco-friendly, yeah, they were selling bags made out of plastic bags. And and that's a thing that you can actually make. You can actually knit things out of plastic bags. So what you do is basically you cut plastic bags into strips and then you knit them together like how you would knit a sweater, for example, like wool. So that's something that you could do together, you know, just have a session with some wine, some food, get some plastic bag, cut them into strips and start learning how to knit together. That could be fun. Or you can do very simple things like one of the things that I've done with my friends before is using tidbit wrappers, like snack wrappers, and making them into, for example, pouches. So you can actually iron them together, fuse them together, and then make a strong plastic material out of it. Yeah, hope I answered that question. So back to my website. So this is where you will see like step-by-step guides. I encourage you to take a look, maybe get some inspiration from there. And you also have some articles about what you can do during Christmas, how you can engage with your kids. And the top right-hand corner, this is where you can join the community. It's completely free. You can bookmark the recipes that you like, come back to them later, and hopefully we get more people who start creating and sharing their recipes as well. What is an easy upcycled gift to make? There's another one. I think there are many. It depends on how big, small, how much effort you actually want to put into it, who it is for. But there are actually quite a number of options on the web of the website itself. Of course, if you're looking at something like upcycling an entire wardrobe or drawer, you know, we've seen some of those on like BuzzFeed.com where they transform an old chest into this fancy, fancily painted ornaments. That's going to take time, that's going to take space. But if it's something as simple as, you know, I've made coasters out of old t-shirts where I basically braid the fabric together, it's really cute and simple. You make 2 to 4 pieces of that coaster, you can give it to your friends and family as gifts. Or even one of the pictures I've shown earlier, making hairpins out of old broken jewelry. You basically take glue, you stick it together. There are many options that you can do for easy upcycling gifts. And on the website, you can also see that some of the recipes are being categorized by the amount of time that is taken to create them and a difficulty level. So really easy for, you know, new people to get started. I myself am not an upcycling expert, but I do have a community of creators who regularly do workshops. So the beautiful necklace that you've seen earlier that's being sold, you know, they learn to do that over time. So start with something simple, and then over time you get better and better with that. Right, so I've come to the end of my session. Thank you for tuning in. I hope that you've gotten some inspiration, and enjoy this Christmas. Merry Christmas.